Hollywood sign. More than just a landmark, it's one of America's greatest icons. It's the living symbol of Hollywood, the entertainment capital of the world. But just like every actor or actress who's headed west with stars in their eyes, the Hollywood sign had modest beginnings. Many people know of its origins, but few remember its subsequent destruction. This is the story of the original Hollywood sign and its resurrection by artist Bill Mack.
I think that that metal, combined with that image, actually pumps blood through the image that I'm painting. There's none of them that weren't connected to that Hollywood sign. It was there before them. It was before any one of them.
Great-grandfather Harry Chandler came up with this idea that why don't we put up this huge big sign on the hills to advertise our development so all of Southern California could see where this was. And the development was called Hollywoodland. The sign eventually got put up in 1923.
With the arrival of the film industry, things changed dramatically, and Hollywood became a destination, not just for tourists. Aspiring actors and actresses, writers and directors, cameramen and cowboys came to Hollywood hoping to work in the movies. By 1978, the Hollywood sign was in real trouble, a sad state for the symbol that meant so much to so many people for more than 50 years. Marilyn Monroe once said, "I used to think as I looked at the Hollywood sign, there must be thousands of girls sitting alone, like me, dreaming of becoming a movie star. But I'm not going to worry about them. I'm dreaming the hardest."
How I got involved in it, it was the 75th anniversary of Hollywood. And I kind of looked at the sign because we lived there and it was falling off the hill. A Hollywood publicity stunt should always be in play. Let's drop an O in Cooper, give it to the sign, so it'll be Alice Cooper, until the rest of the letters get up. The idea of taking the O off, putting it on the thing, physically doing it, and saying, "I believe in Hollywood. The Hollywood sign needs to be brand new and nobody's taking care of it. So it's up to us entertainers to do the sign." And it was a challenge. I just kind of threw the gauntlet out.
Surprisingly, Alice Cooper's challenge to Hollywood was answered faster than he thought possible.
Hugh Hefner and many others were stepping forward.
It was just everybody had an idea about what letter they wanted to buy.
Then Andy Williams bought the W.
Gene Autry, you know, who always rode to the rescue every Saturday morning, he rode to the rescue of Hollywood.
They all bought letters, and that initiated bringing the new sign as you see it today.
The new sign carried on the tradition of the original. But whatever happened to the original sign? The original metal sign had been moved to a warehouse in Orange County, California, until disco promoter Hank Berger acquired it from the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce. Berger left the sign in storage for nearly 30 years. Until 2005, when entrepreneur Dan Bliss bought it from Hank Berger. Then Bliss contacted Bill Mack.
Called me, asked me if I'd like to buy the Hollywood sign. We can imagine the reaction. I mean, how in the world? First reaction is maybe hang up on him, and then about 30 minutes later, after he'd taken the time to explain it all, I understood that they had front panels from the original Hollywood sign.
He flew out to Los Angeles, saw the material. He then leased a semi-truck and loaded the whole sign into the truck, and then the truck traveled across the country to Minneapolis and took the sign to his studio.
For the first time since 1923, the Hollywood sign no longer resided in the state of California.
Every time I left my office, I looked at it and thought, you know, trying to imagine what am I doing with it. And I decided to paint a portrait or image of Jean Harlow, one of the first real Hollywood iconic stars, and put her on that piece of metal for my own collection. The Hollywood sign is bigger than any single star, is bigger than any single character, bigger than any single movie.
honor of Hugh Hefner's contributions to the sign, Bill created a special painting of Hef, which now hangs in the Playboy Mansion. In 2013, Bill Mack committed to his greatest challenge yet, the reconstruction of the original Hollywood H. Bill Mack did in fact complete the legendary letter H.
Through a labor of love, reassembled the H. That anyone would have that dedication to the Hollywood sign to bring back the actual original letter.
With the restoration of the letter H complete, the original Hollywood sign will build a new legacy for generations to come. What started out as a simple real estate advertisement has become the most recognizable sign in the world.
The sign where it says Hollywood, those are magic letters. That's a magic word.
The Hollywood sign perpetuated the mystique of Hollywood.
Every single megastar and every director and everything knew that sign. It was so much a part of their life.